we did hear Mikey. Okay.
Yep.
Yes, we did. It's Mikey.
Hooray! Hooray,
is
hooray.
Dory Dog here today,
I'll probably
Mikey?
Add everybody to a party and we'll just go that way. Then we can do a private instance so we don't.
Okay. Alrighty. I'll add that into the instructions. For the beginning of our service, we'll do a little bit of introduction and announcements of what we're doing, and then we can go through a time of adding into the party, and I'll try to chase Pat around and try to get him in here. But
okay.
Hear ye, we are ready to start for all of you, anybody else that's coming from the back there, we are ready. And to your question, Susie, I did not bring Victoria today because she was kind of sitting around relaxing. I saw her there, and she was and we have barely enough internet. I'm barely hanging on with enough internet today for Pat over here, the streaming and all that.
He's got his head in the tree.
I didn't bring that up because I figured it would be a little bit more taxing on the internet.
He's hiding.
Yeah, probably.
But he's not.
Oh, look at that. He's got to be scratching the side of his head there on
we
that
can
tree.
We can still see you, Pat. We can still see you.
Well, he doesn't have his head in the clouds.
Not this time.
Well, look at that. He can't even jump. Oh, there he can jump. Oh, messed him up just a little bit. Okay, there we go. All right. So, so for those of you that have made it today, it's good to have you. So I see some new faces today. That's awesome. Thanks for stopping by and checking out what we've got going on. We've got a special today. For those of you that aren't aware, we have church here every Sunday afternoon at 4 Eastern. We actually, a half an hour earlier, at 3:30 Eastern, we're over at Killer Bee Studios with the time of anybody that wants to volunteer to sing a song, some sort of worship or hymn song or anything like that, or any kind of testimony or prayer request. We do a lot of that. We didn't do that today because of the holidays, but be sure to follow us, whoever around here, and try to keep and look at all the different little signs around, and you can get an idea of what's going on. And as far as also as getting an idea of what's going on the back wall way up in the sky in giant letters are two different Facebook groups that are just great to be in if you're interested in either A, with the top one following things that the church are doing, having your prayer request or praise report or any kind of thing there and seeing what's going on with the church specifically, or Horizon World Christian Community is very good for just if you happen to want to try to figure out what's going on and you're just bored and you want to look around at the schedule and different churches doing different things. Totally open, and we do stream live on Twitch. So right now this robot guy over here is streaming to Twitch on my username on Twitch. You can sign up to Twitch, follow me, MetaMikey7777, and watch it there. Otherwise, we do also have various things throughout the week going on. You'll keep an eye on those two different groups or whatever. We do have a Bible study on Saturday nights at 9 Eastern every week, where we just slowly have an open discussion and go through whatever book. Right now we're going through the book of Acts really, really slowly, just kind of talking amongst ourselves and reading through it. I've typed it up there. Monday nights, we've been having a men's and women's group at 8 Eastern, but lately for the holidays, we've been doing just kind of a prayer and game night where people get together and for a little short bit of touching up on any prayer needs and fellowship things, and then going out and playing games. So there's all kinds of things going on. Be sure to chase us around if you're bored in the metaverse, or even if you're not bored, it's very good. Let's see. So today, Art Girl's going to go around and maybe somebody will be helping her too to get us all in a party, because we're going to be going to some special worlds and we're going to try to get there together. If you happen to get stuck in a world where, wait a minute, I thought everybody was supposed to be here. I would recommend, if it was me, if I got stuck in a world where I was in another copy of the same world without everybody else, I would go to my apartment, look for somebody that I know is there, and then join on them. Because sometimes, you know, either way, you're going to join on them if you get lost.
Will that work if we're in a private instance, though? They might just have to send one of us a...
Oh, yeah. That's the other thing. The code that we use around Horizon Worlds is if we see somebody we can't get to them, we send them thanks. So if we're ever in a world where it's a private instance and you can't join, then you just send somebody in their thanks and they will invite you. So that's a neat little trick. I guess that's it for the announcements. I'm going to say a prayer, an opening prayer for our service of wandering around today. Oh, one more little bit of instruction. I'm going to be trying to chase after us with this bot, and he's really hard to motivate. So each time we get to a world, we'll be kind of going around for a couple minutes, kind of looking and talking amongst ourselves while he finally catches up with us. But other than that, I'm going to say a prayer and we'll just go through and then see what all we have to go through today. So, Father, we come to you in Jesus' name, and we thank you for this opportunity to get together today. We thank you for the possibilities that you have made for us to come into this metaverse, into this horizon worlds, and have fellowship, Bible study, prayer, and all the different things we'll be able to do. And we thank you for all the wonderful relationships that you've given us, and you're helping us to grow and spread the Great Commission in a new and spectacular way in here. So, Father, bless this time that we have together today, looking at these different worlds and the story that they tell. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Okay. So Art Girl is now going to maybe you can add somebody to a party, like
yeah.
Good Soldier, somebody. Or they can start working on people on that side, and you can start working on people on that side, and adding to the party. Now to find a good place for him to stand. Let's see, where should Pat stand?
Probably over where you're at.
Oh, okay.
He seems to like trees.
I'm gonna go get you down.
Don't go over there. Well, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and move. Oh, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah, let me know when you're ready.
Okay, everything seems to be ready. Pat looks like he's a little bit contorted, but that's
Pat, do you wanna push it?
His problem.
Oh, the first one. Yep. What do you want to do, the song or the narration?
No, the headphones first, the narration first.
Here we go.
Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, for the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great, and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, the Holy One, who is to be born, will be called the Son of God. Now indeed, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is now the sixth month for her who was called barren. For with God nothing will be impossible." Then Mary said, "Behold, the maidservant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her.
Okay, and then Dawn sang a nice song for this world for us.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels tread? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know?
love that
awesome
song.
Awesome.
Okay, so, we're gonna travel to the
I'll tell you what, Art Girl, while we're here, and we have some people in the room, does anybody have anything they feel like they'd like to share about that they might trivia or anything like that about the this particular scene when the angel came and Mary became pregnant and things like that? But just wanted to make sure that we had an opportunity to talk about it. If anybody had anything they'd like to share,
I do.
Go ahead. Yes.
Okay. When I made this world, I had a woman angel up there, and then I talked to Lep, and he let me know that angels were all male, right? So I changed the angel. He's kind of looks like he could be either, really, but I did not know that, though. I didn't know all angels were male.
I didn't know that either.
Oh, right.
So there's some trivia.
And the one that appeared to Mary was Gabriel.
Yeah, the one that appeared to Mary was Gabriel.
So
he's definitely a man.
He was a male. And if there were female angels, it was still the men that were sent to.
It's okay.
Awesome. So many prophecies from the Old Testament leading up to this point for hundreds of years, like Isaiah 7:14. Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin will be with child and bear a son, and she will call his name Emmanuel. And here he is. And then later on, well, we're not to that part yet, but he's going to be born in Bethlehem, which is called the house of bread. And Jesus is the bread of life. So there's all kinds of neat things you can dig into about that you haven't heard of a lot of times in the nativity story. So that's awesome. This is great. I love to see you guys made this.
VR fun. Did you get an invite to join the party? Because I don't think
No, I did not. I thought this was church.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Oh, it is okay. Oh,
yeah,
was I supposed
to?
Music you put in there, Cops, that sounds so cool.
Yeah,
Cops.
Yeah, it is.
Cops,
beautiful.
You need to do, you can do that for a living. You do that very, very well. Cool.
Well,
you
thank
do that
you.
Very well.
It took many takes without being, you know, messing up.
Yeah, she worked hard and long on this for a long time.
Yeah, she did.
Oh, thank you.
She is a very good narrator.
Well, I love doing this for everybody, you know. Yeah. I love doing. So if anybody needs narration, would love to help you guys. Because now I know how to bring in sound to Horizon, because I did all of this sound recording on my new professional microphone. And then I imported everything, all the sounds, into Horizon. So if anybody needs any songs imported or anything like that, let me know. I'll be more than welcome to help. More than happy to help.
Yeah, it's excellent. It sounds excellent.
Hey, Joe. How's it going?
Does anybody have anything to add to this world before we go to the next?
It's beautiful.
Oh, I am.
Go ahead.
I could actually go
ahead, Ninth.
You could go down the doors.
I heard a story the other day. They kind of took a little liberty, but they wrote a story about how Jesus, how Mary and Joseph showed up at the innkeeper's house, and then whenever they didn't run, they ran out of room, and that's whenever the innkeeper was like, "Oh, I don't have any rooms," and he sent them to the manger. I don't know if that actually happened or if they just put that completely liberty, you know, on the storyteller's part, but. The moral is like, don't be the innkeeper and have the last door of your door and some
book. Yeah.
Yes.
I got it.
Awesome.
Sure. All right.
What's that?
Great job, everybody. Thanks for that, Ninth.
Let him in.
Yeah.
Let him in.
Yeah.
Your heart.
Yeah. Let him in. I stand at the door.
Yeah, I stand at the door and knock. Yes, mm-hmm. that's a good verse. I like that one.
Okay, we're gonna go to part three.
Did you invite me and Pat once you get there?
Good job singing it. Did you sing Chuki? Did you sing that?
That was
lovely.
Thank you.
No orphans left behind. We lost you, Don.
There he is. You pointed the wrong way, Pat. There's Lady Hawk. Let's say add her to
Lady
our
Hawk
thing here.
Hello. Hi, Lady Hawk.
I'm going to add you to our party that you can travel with us, okay, Lady Hawk? So check your wrist.
You. All right, thank you.
And don't go by the buttons because they will go off before we want
to. Oh, wow,
but
everybody's jumping on the sheep.
Sheep jump. You've heard cow tipping, right?
That's because I've been bad.
How many sheep can you
Merry
jump
Christmas,
into that
Lady Hawk. Thank you.
It's not cow tipping, it's sheep jumping.
Yeah.
No, it's mutton busting. It's called mutton busting. Okay, are you ready, Mikey?
Yeah, everything is all systems are go, yes.
Mm-hmm. Now they were in the same country, shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. Now, when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told them concerning this child, and all those who heard it marveled at the things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good.
Did the narration, and then I don't know, it just came to me like I can just put some dramatization music with it.
No, that idea in your head, huh?
thank you, Holy Spirit.
So now we have Diener.
Yeah.
Thank you, good Diener sang a song for us for this world, so we're gonna hear her song now.
Oh, holy night. The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world and sin in error pining, till ye appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees. Oh, hear the angels' voices. Oh, night divine. When Christ was born, oh, night divine, oh, night divine.
Yay! All
right. Oh, nice. That was nice. So, does anybody have anything they want to add to this world before we go to the next one?
No,
okay. All right, let's go to the next world then.
Okay, same drill. Somebody invite Pat and me once they get there.
Okay. Oh, this thing is from my face. I can't see. Okay, wait a second. I had it right in front of me, and then something got in front of my face, a sign, and I couldn't see. So I need to start again.
I hear crickets.
Yeah. Okay, let's see here.
I love the cricket sounds. That's great.
Okay. All right, so... here we go. Anybody that gets lost or doesn't go with us, just send us a thanks and we'll get you. VR fun, we need you.
VR.
Did he?
Where are you?
Where is
VR,
he at?
VR fun.
I don't know.
I don't see him.
Did we lose him?
Is he in here?
I don't even see him.
VR, are you here?
He was a coin earlier.
All right. I think he might be gone. Right, he was. All right, well, we'll go. But if there's Pat. About yourself and there's Pat. Just watch you don't bump those buttons, guys.
Oh, I see. So you have the next part there. Okay, that's good.
Pat beat you again. Oh, no, Mikey's over there. Okay.
Mikey's here.
All right, are we ready?
I'm ready.
We are. Okay.
Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east and have come to worship him. When Herod heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who shall shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star had appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for this young child. And when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way.
Very nice.
The song in here is sung by Pastor Mike's wife.
Woohoo! I had never heard that song before. It was really beautiful.
Yeah.
Kings of earth on a course unknown, bearing gifts from afar, hoping, praying, following yonder star. Silhouette of a caravan painted against the sky. Wise men searching for the holy child. One king held the frankincense, one king held the myrrh, one king held the purest gold, one king held the love of the world. A star hangs over Bethlehem, a journey ends in the night. Three kings trembling behold the glorious sight. Heaven's treasure, Emmanuel, drawing men to bow down.
One king held the purest gold, one king.
was.
Yeah, I know. I've never heard it before, but oh my gosh, her voice is so pretty.
It's like a, it's almost like a haunting. It's like a haunting song.
Yeah.
Our youngest is here. Do you want to just finish off hopping the last world? She's talking to the sister there.
Very cool.
Good.
Okay, so we have one more world to go to. Is everybody ready?
Yeah, he is.
Oh, I love it. He looks so peaceful, doesn't he?
He does.
If you go up there and across, you can jump up onto the top where the angel is. Geeky.
Oh, I think we all have to try that now.
Go across and you can jump onto the roof. There. Like Ninth just did.
Come on, good shoulder. I'm following.
I get you.
This is what we do for church. We climb things.
Yeah, we climb things. Oh, we stand on angels and we jump on sheep.
Welcome to church. See if you can climb all the way to the top of everything.
Well, this is your assignment for today.
I just want to.
Today's lesson is how to jump on top of the angel.
This is what your training's been for.
Oh, look at Mikey's
like way up there.
What? How'd you get up
All
there?
Right, so
wait, Mikey, I gotta get a picture.
We're gonna go ahead with this one.
Yeah, it is.
The birth of Christ, a momentous event in Bethlehem over 2,000 years ago, encapsulates the essence of Christmas and its profound significance. In the humblest of settings, Jesus came
to the world
as a beacon of hope and divine love. His arrival marks the true reason for the season, a celebration not just of historical birth, but of the spiritual rebirth that Christ's presence brings. Christmas is the reminder of God's gift to humanity, offering salvation, grace, and a pathway to a life of compassion and purpose. As we partake in the festivities and exchange gifts, let us not forget the core of this joyous occasion, the birth of Jesus Christ. His teachings call us to follow in his footsteps, embodying love and kindness in our lives. This Christmas, let the true meaning of the season resonate within us, inspiring a shared celebration of the transformative impact of Christ's birth and his timeless message of hope and salvation that he brings to us all. As you lay down your worries and rest in the embrace of this silent night, may you find the serenity that Christ brings. Let the joy of Christmas fill your spirit with hope, love, and peace. Wishing you a Christmas filled with the beauty of silent night and the timeless joy it brings. May your days be merry and bright, and your heart be filled with the warmth of the season. Merry Christmas.
Aww, that was so good, Cop. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
You're so awesome.
That was
awesome. Amazing.
You are so talented. Awesome.
Cops is the awesomest.
Yes, she is.
I love your build, though. You know, it's a collaboration of build and narration and the magic of Christmas and the birth of our Savior.
Mm-hmm. And all the people that sang were so good, too. We have two special songs left. One is by Pastor Mikey. We'll hear him first. And the other one is
the bottom. His is the bottom.
Yeah, I realized that earlier.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down.
And now we have
the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The
That was so cute.
Yay. That was awesome.
Oh my gosh, she's so
That was
cute.
Beautiful. I loved it.
So
ends the tour. I hope everybody enjoyed it.
Thank you so much, Art Girl. This was beautiful.
Thank you, Cops.
Thank you so much, Cops, and everybody else, and everybody that sang, and Mikey, and your wife, and daughter, and Dawn, and Diener, and Chucky, everybody. It was a group.
That was awesome.
Very well. It was. Very good.
Thank Yadian, too. I haven't seen him in forever, but if you see
I
him.
I will.
Yeah.
Oh, you're welcome.
Yeah,
thank you. Uh-huh. Mm. I changed it a little. I changed the faces of the people and changed the sheep, and I don't know what else I changed, a bunch of stuff.
Well, guys, I have to go because my family is celebrating, so I'm supposed to be there at 5, but I wanted to stay here with you good people for a little bit. But I'm going to head out. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming. And Art Girl, thank you for having me collaborate with you. It was wonderful.
Oh, my gosh. Anytime.
Merry
Anytime.
Christmas, everybody.
Merry
God bless.
Christmas.
Yeah.
Merry Christmas, Cops.
Bye-bye.
Love
you.
Oh, by the Cops, before you leave, if you can hear me, we still, we're teaching Enderly the little ducks. Oh, she's gone. But you know what I was going to say, girl, because you heard
the little
it.
Duck song.
Little...
Uh-huh.
Yes, we're teaching them little duck song.
Oh, cool.
Aww. I can't believe a year's have gone by already. That went fast.
No. Yeah, it did.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. You were just having them like 2 days ago.
I know. It feels like it. But
I know.
He's getting so big. I'll send you some pictures soon.
Yeah, I want to see some pictures. I asked Polly for some, but she didn't.
Amen.
Right,
thank you, Lev.
Amen.
Have a good Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thanks for coming.
Wow. That was...
Geeky, you hung in there the whole time.
Nice.
Yay!
What?
Yeah.
I said you hung in there. Good.
Yeah. I'd stay.
Yeah.
That's a cool shirt, by the way. A multicolored plaid shirt. I love it.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I've worn it since the beginning.
They call it.
I wore the first coat thingy for like the first 8 months, and I said, you know what? I better take this thing off every once in a while. It's been on for 8 months.
And
when I first got into Horizon.
Us girls, we change like 5 times a day. Like always changing.
Wait.
Right, I'm glad all those buttons worked. I was so nervous they were gonna mess up like they were the